I see a lot of congress they've got. We have, in our presence, some journalists here. We are going to be now giving our press release, press statement, and just updating the media on the just ended congress and our resolutions. I would like to introduce our general secretary, Comrade Mabuto Nicholas Mapena, who is going to be heading the media briefing. Comrade Mapena.
Thank you so much, National Spokesperson. Thanks a lot to journalists. With me on my left is Comrade Philemon Nema, the newly elected National Chairperson of the Zimbabwe Communist Party. He's from Harare, he's based in Harare. His rural home is somewhere in Manicaland. I'm from Matabele in South, though currently based in Johannesburg. The spokesperson is from Mad North, though based in Johannesburg. We have among us that's a woman I've not introduced, though members of the Central Committee that are here. We held the congress from yesterday to this day under the theme Completing the Liberation of Zimbabwe. We will not read our documents in terms of what we discussed, but what the Congress did was to receive the political report of what we called the National Steering Committee, which was the structure of the Zimbabwe Communist Party that was elected on the 28th of April 2017. The mandate given by the founding conference was that the National Steering Committee must work towards convening a congress, and that means building structures countrywide. So the National Steering Committee did its work, then it convened this congress. Once the congress was convened, the congress discussed the progress report, which was presented by the National Steering Committee. It discussed the what was then the draft, which might appear in the documents that you have, the draft political program of the party. We had to then dissolve the National Steering Committee and elect the Central Committee in this congress. So the leadership of the Zimbabwe Communist Party as it stands today is led by the following comrades, which I will name. I've already been introduced as the General Secretary. I've already introduced the National Chairman, Comrade Philemon Nema, who's from Manicaland but based in Harare. Our Deputy General Secretary, Ed Opet Masaure, is based in Harare but is from Mashonaland East. Our Treasurer General, Comrade Fabio Ngomo, is from Matabele North. He also stays in Bulawayo but is from Matabele North. Our Deputy National Chairperson, Lorraine Mnube, who's from Mad South, also based in Bulawayo. We then created the Congress, then resolved that in order to build the party, recruiting, build the structures, because we're guided by the reports that were presented by the National Steering Committee, the political report and the organizational report. So the Congress then was of the view that in order to build the structures, we needed then to establish what we now call the Organizational Bureau, which has its chair. And the chair is Comrade Trust Mazum Kwananzi. He's from Mad North, but based in Bulawayo. The secretary of the Organizational Bureau is Comrade Jusa Uterezera. He's from Manicaland, stays in Dar. We then have the National Commissar, Comrade Ian Meadows, the comrade that has been giving new pamphlets or our documents. He's doing his work as the commissar. He's currently based in Johannesburg. We have the Deputy National Commissar, Prudence Sauriri. He's based in from Manicaland, stays in Dare. We then have elected Comrade Itai Simunya from Manicaland, Secretary of International Relations. I've already introduced Comrade Bongani Mkhwanazi here, who is the Secretary for Information and Publicity. We elected Comrade Lenny Mchisaira as Secretary for Legal Affairs and Environment. Comrade Lenin is based in Harare. We have a comrade from Shona and the West, Comrade James Akana, who is the head of our security. Yeah, we have Comrade Benny Moyo, based in Bulawayo, Secretary for Research and Policy Foundation. We have Comrade Benny Mlalas, who is from Mat South, is in Johannesburg, is Secretary for Development. Because he is a Communist Party, the vanguard of the working class, and presents a party that does not believe in foreign direct investment. We believe that Zimbabweans, through cooperatives and other investments, can rebuild the economy. So Comrade Ben Mlalas is tasked by this Congress, together with the Central Committee, to develop strategies on how we rebuild our economy. Then we have Comrade Abedinko Skuni, additional member of the Central Committee. So that's the leadership that was elected in this Congress. So what we then did in terms of our work, which were mandated by the Congress, I would simply highlight just a few things before we then open for discussion. To say, for us to go forward,